what?
Hello? Yeah? He's out right now. Alright, yeah, here he is.
Hello?
Heard
Mom?
You.
How many times
yeah,
is this?
Turned off
like,
your,
60
yeah,
minutes?
I turned off the stove. Yeah, I'm sure. Oh yeah, well you're a disappointment to me too. Hello? Yeah? Yeah, I'm sorry. Don't come home at 8. Yeah, I'll pick up your medicine. Okay. Love you. Bye. Mothers. Ma! You can't... Oh, sorry, Chief. Tell him I'm sorry.
Hey, he's sorry. Yeah, Chief. I got murder. I'll transfer you over.
Hello? Murder? Alright, can I have the name? Alright, age... Location, quarter mile, sharp shopper. All right, we'll send somebody right over. All right, bye. Well, guys, murder on our hands.
So is he okay?
Pablo, he's dead. He's not gonna come back. He's dead.
He could be fine.
So, anyway. God. Name, Paco Rodriguez, age 16 to 17. Body's located a fourth of a mile past a sharp shopper in Knox.
Mm-hmm.
So,
my wife goes shopping there quite often.
I heard they got pretty good prices.
Nah, they rip you off.
Okay. Anyway, we should probably get down there.
Alright, let's do this.
Hey, we going to Dunkin' Donuts?
Why not?
Okay, Tony's buying.
Woo! No, I'm not.
What happened? Oh my gosh. This must be my kidney can. Oh my god, it's great. It's just what I ordered.
Come in. Hey, did you find the prints?
Yeah.
Good. Found some hair.
Alright, I'll show up there for you.
Okay, good luck.
Yep.
Alright. Looks like we know who these are from.
I wonder if old Pablo's got that forensics for us.
I don't know. I hope so.
Yeah, me too. Come on, get that. Hey,
Andy.
I found out who our murderer is. It's Jason Johnson.
Okay. Guess we can review some personal files on this guy and
yeah, let's just go get the guy. Come on.
Let's go. Don't want you for the weekend. Don't want you for a night. I'm only interested if I can help you for life. Yeah. I know I sound serious. Baby, I am. You're a fine piece of real estate and I'm gonna get me some land.
Shut up, you're Batman!
Ow!
Oh.
Screw you!
off the guys. We're all friends. We can all play together. We can share this cool.
Yeah, no, we can stop it now.
Yeah, we can share. Okay?
Yeah, well, we can play together.
Oh, alright, Scrooge. Yeah. We'll be friends.
I want to get in on this.
Yeah.
Wake up. What's your name?
What is that, some sort of question?
Yes.
And so it is.
Where were you May 4th at 2 in the afternoon?
That was a Saturday.
I was in La La Land. Somebody bring me the file on this dude. Thanks.
I have a question for the guy. If you were in La La Land, then why was your DNA found on the murder weapon?
La La Land is a very magical place, sir.
Ow.
Okay, Mr. Johnson, let's see. Ain't looking good for you, buddy. We have your fingerprints on the murder weapon. Your hair was found at the crime
scene. Yeah. What's the damage?
The damage is possible life in prison without parole.
I always don't have to pay anything. Stupid government.
Okay. Do you recognize this man?
Never seen him in my entire life.
I find that hard to believe.
Well, you never believed in imagination, haven't you?
Considering you're the man who murdered him.
What are you talking about, you crazy person?
We found your hair.
We know you did it. Just admit to doing it, and we'll see about striking a deal.
How about no?
Okay. Playing hardball, huh?
I play baseball. Yeah.
Thank you, Batman. Now, there's two ways we can do this. We can drag you out of here and beat you until you confess, or you can just confess now and save us all a lot of trouble.
How about option three, where you give me $100 and I go out of here on my Ferrari?
No.
Well, that's the only chance I'm gonna take.
That's it. Come on.
Oh, God. Where are you taking me?
Come on.
Oh, you're gonna beat me up, aren't you, with your girly arms?
Come on.
You don't have the guts to beat the crap out of me.
You ready to confess now, boy?
I guess you do have the guts, but I'm still not confessing. Yeah.
We know you did it. We have your weapon, and we have like 4 witnesses that say they saw you.
You still can't prove it.
Yes, we can. Our forensic scientist here will explain to you why, a.k.a. Batman.
Well, I sampled your DNA and your hair and it traced right back.
Blah, 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 science talk. That's all I want
now. Shut up.
Now you can either confess and walk out of here with...
I'll die before I confess.
We can make that happen.
Well, I bet you can't.
Yes, you can. Do you want to take the chance on that?
I sure as hell would.
This guy ain't talking.
Chief!
Yeah?
He's all yours.
Talk. You did it. Confess. How about no?
Look, we can do this all day.
I'm sure we can.
I got nowhere to be.
I bet you don't. Talk.
We can do this all day. Confess.
I don't care what you say, I'm still not confessing.
Confess.
I was trained by the army not
to
confess.
Look, I'll give you one more chance. Confess.
Confess!
We got another call witnessing you at the murder.
So that's 5, isn't it?
Yes. That's 5 people with perfectly clean backgrounds that had saw you there.
Now I'm bored anyways. Go ahead, take me. I don't give a crap.
Did you commit the murder?
Sure, why the heck not? I don't know.
I'm gonna get the lawyer up here!
10 minutes!
She's crazy. She is!
I'll get
Jesus!
Man,
don't
even
create my life.
Alright, I better go calm that woman down.
You better. She's go. Pretty crazy, man.
I know.
What the heck? I thought she was gonna hit me with that. You know what I think? She was aiming for me.
Have a seat, man.
Do you have some water, please?
You can call her.
I need to calm down.
Alright.
I think you owe him an apology.
I'll get to him later. Right now, we have to get down to business. Okay, officer?
Alright. My name's Officer McLean.
You know who I am.
Yes, I do. Alright, where were you at the time of the murder?
Let me get a breather. I was mowing my yard.
Okay. What time was that, man?
Let me guess, or think. I want to say roughly around 2:30, 3 o'clock.
Alright, where was your son?
He was at a friend's house.
Alright. When did you... Why did we find your son's prints on the gun board?
I have no idea. We had no weapons. I couldn't even begin to tell you. If it is his prints,
well,
why is it on the gun? We don't have no weapons. I don't know.
Does your son have a past of violence?
Yes, he does. He has a medical condition that needs medication to control his behavior.
What's the problem?
The problem with his behavior,
yeah.
Or with what he's being accused of?
What's his behavior?
Could you elaborate on
that? Well, I heard past that the neighbor's been had some problems with neighbors.
Yes. We have no trespassing signs up on our property. And they keep coming over, not paying attention to the signs. And Jason would just go nuts. Yelling wise, no physical contact, nothing. He would just be very vocal about his displeasure.
Okay. How long has this been going on?
We've been in the house 3 years. So I want to say maybe 2.5 years.
Yeah, do you own any weapons?
I personally don't. And that I'm aware of, there's none in our house.
Have any weapons been involved in these reactions of your son and the neighbors?
Maybe a few times, but it was our neighbors who had the weapons, not Jason.
Kind of evidence? Or weapons?
Let me think. I've seen a rifle, and there was some knives.
What bloody man is that? He can report at Seamoth by his plight of the revolt, the new estate.
This is the sergeant who, like a good and hardy soldier, fought against my captivity. Hail, brave friend. Say to the king the knowledge of the broil as thou didst leave it.
Doubtful it stood, as two spent swimmers that do cling together and choke their art. The merciless McDonwall, worthy to be a rebel for that the multiple villainies of nature do swarm upon him. From the western isles of Kearns and gallows glass is supplied, and fortune, like Valier's minion, curved out his passage till he faced the slaves which never shook hands nor blade farewell to him, till he unseamed him from the nave to the chops and fixed his head upon our battlements.
A valiant cousin, worthy gentleman.
As once the sun gained his reflection, shipwreck, storms, and direful thunder break. So from that spring one's comfort seemed to come discomfort swells. Mark, King of Scotland, Mark, no sooner justice had the Baber arm compelled these skipping currents to their trust their heels. But the Norwegian lord surveys vantage with foolish arms and new supplies of men bring a fresh assault.
Dismay not this, our captain's Macbeth and bankroll.
Yes, a sparrow is evil, or the hare is a lion. If I say so, if I must report, they were as cannons overcharged with double crack, so they doubly redoubled strokes upon the foe. Except they went into battle and reaped wounds and mesmerized another Gogolosh. I cannot tell, but I am faint. My gashes cry for help.
So why thee as thy wounds? They smack the honor both. Go get him, surgeons.
The worthy thane of Ross.
What a haste looks through his eyes. So should he look that seems to speak things strange.
God save the king.
Whence camest thou, worthy thane?
Where the Norwegian banners float, the sky and fan our people cold. Norway himself, with terrible numbers, assisted by that most disloyal, the thane of Carlin, began a dismal conflict till the Bologna bridegroom, lapped in proof, confronted him. With self-comparison, point against point, rebellious arm against arm, curbing his loyal spirit, and to conclude the victory fell on us. That now Sweno, the Norway's king, grows comparison, nor would we deny him burial of his men till he dispersed at St. Columb's inch 10,000 callers to our general use.
No more that thane of Cawdor shall deceive our bosom interest. Go pronounce death and with his former title greet Macbeth.
I'll see it done.
What hath lost, noble Macbeth hath won. Is execution done on Cawdor? Are not those in commission yet returned?
My liege, they are not yet come back, but I have spoke with one that saw him die, who did report that very frankly he confessed his treasons, implored your highness's pardon, and set forth a deep repentance. Nothing in his life became him like the leaving it. He died as one that had been studied in his death to throw away the dearest thing he owed, as 'twere a careless trifle.
There's no art to find the mind's construction in the face. He was a gentleman on whom I built an absolute trust. O worthiest cousin, the sin of my ingratitude even now was heavy on me. Thou art so far before the swiftest wing of recompense is slow to overtake thee. Would thou hadst less deserved that the proportion both of thanks and payment might have been mine. Only I have left to say, more is thy due than more than all can pay.
The service and the loyalty I owe in doing it pays itself. Your Highness's part is to receive our duties, and to our duties or to your throne and state, child, children, and servants, which do but what they should by doing everything safe toward your love and honor.
Welcome hither. I have begun to plant thee and will labor to make these full of growing. Noble Banquo, that hast not less deserved, nor must be known no less to have done so. Let me unfold thee and hold thee to my heart.
There if I grow, the harvest is your own.
By plenteous joys, wanton is fullness, seek to hide themselves in drops of sorrow. Sons, kinsmen, thanes, and you whose places are the nearest now, we will establish our estate upon our eldest, Malcolm, who we name hereafter the Prince of Cumberland, which honor must not unaccompanied invest him only, but signs of nobleness like stars will shine on all deservers. From hence in Inverness and bind us further to you.
The rest is labor, which is not used for you. I'll be myself the harbinger and make joyful the hearing of my wife with your approach. So humbly take my leave.
My worthy Cawdor.
The Prince of Cumberland, this is a step on which I must fall down or else or leap. For in my way it lies. Stars, hide your fires. Let not light see my black and deep desires. The eye wink at the hand, yet let that be which the eye fears. When it's done, when it is done to see.
True worthy Banquo, he is so valiant, and in his commendations I am fed. It is a banquet to me. Let's after him. Whose care is gone before to bid us welcome? It is a peerless kinsman.